And welcome in to a holiday weekend, at least in the United States, edition of the Fun Astrology Podcast. Thomas Miller back, and I'm going to cover the weekend in one here. So we'll just get you covered and scrubbed up because really the pattern is all Virgo all weekend. That's what it is. And I'm going to give you an example real quick of how the Virgo weekend might show up for you. So where we are, just to begin the weekend, the moon is still in Virgo. So we have this super steroided stellium, stellium being three or more planets in the same sign or house. Listen to this stack. Mercury, 4 degrees. Sun, 7 degrees. Mars, 8 degrees. Venus, 12 degrees. And the moon, 23 degrees, all in Virgo. Like, wow. So wherever that moves around in your chart and in your life is just stacking energy, just like we had this summer, basically. And this is a really powerful stack. But the great part is that we have some favorable aspects. But before I mention that, let's talk about the moon. Moon is at 23 degrees. Moon moves the fastest around the chart. So it's going to exit stage right later Saturday evening. Exact time, 6:08 p.m. Catch yesterday's episode for all the information on the new moon. But if you are still doing some new moon creating, manifesting, setting intentions work to catch that energy, do it before 6 p.m. Saturday. Because once the moon steps out, that will pretty much be printed and given to the universe at that point. But two things stay with us through the weekend, and these are the things to key on. Really, there are three elements of the weekend energetically. There's the big stellium, just this power punch Virgo energy. Second is the trine with Uranus. So changes over this weekend are going to be favorable. They're going to be supported. It's not going to be weird-ass Uranus coming at you from, you know, blind side. I mean, Uranus is Uranus, but there's a favorable element to it. And yeah, it's all tied to Mercury, speech, sun, your projection, who you are, the persona you, the radiant you. And we've got Mars in there as well. So there could be a powerful change. I mean, it could be a wallop, could be a good one. And we got to consider Venus in there as well at 12 degrees. That's a 6 degree aspect from where Uranus is. So that's at play as well. And when we throw that Virgo element on it, then you've got that foundation and that structure and that good grounding and that get it done element. So how did I apply this? Well, yesterday there was a room in the house here that just needed some attention. It had been the throw room. You have one of those. And last night, Majana and I got in there and we nailed that thing. I mean, got it all done. See, that's Virgo, and got it done in a fairly short period of time. So it's organized, it's clean, everything is taken care of and either taken to the dumpster or to the recycle bin or to the storage unit. I just moved it. But if you move it, you move it, and at least it's out of sight, and now that room is back to functional again. And there were some pictures, wall-hanging type stuff in the closet. She's going to address that today. I have two boxes of stuff. I'm not a paper person. I have moved my whole world to the electronic realm. I hardly ever take up a pen, literally, except to write in my journal. That's really when I ever write anymore. And on my glass top desk when I'm making notes about podcasts. Everything else I do is on a notes program or in the computer in some way. But I have two boxes of receipts and papers and just stuff. Guess what I'm going to do this weekend? Get through that box. See, that's how you can use that Virgo energy. And it's almost, it's like it's so there that I want to get it done. And, you know, at that point where I go, just delay. No, this is the weekend to get it done. So if you have some lingering projects, nail them. All right. And then the other favorable aspect is this trine with Saturn. And yes, one could even argue that we've got a grand trine here. Yesterday I said no. Today I'm changing my mind. It's a wide orb, but between the sun and Uranus, that's a dead spot on trine between the sun and Saturn. 7 degrees. So those of you who study astrology and orbs, how wide do you want to go on a trine? And then we've got a 7 degree, 8 degree spread between Uranus and Saturn. So some people would argue, no, 8 is too wide for a trine. I'm talking astro ease here just because I don't that often. And you know what? It doesn't hurt to listen in. You can look all this stuff up. Google, if this is like foreign language, Google it. Because this is really a great way to learn astrology. And for those of you who are and listening and you're going, this guy's crazy. Anyway, possibly you'd have to stretch. You'd have to stretch that 8 degrees. But if you wanted to, and look, since we could bring that energy in, then let's use Saturn's grounding. Let's use Saturn's structure. And, you know, I was doing a reading yesterday and just talking about Saturn from a benefic standpoint of discipline, completion, structure, order, all of the good parts of Saturn. When you get on Saturn's good side, then you get some real grounding. Build it for the future. Don't build it just for tomorrow kind of thing. And that energy is definitely in the air for this weekend. So just pull it all together. Why not? Go out there and grab that wide orb. Great Virgo energy. Some get-her-done Uranus, like shake-it-up-a-little-bit energy. And build it with a great base for the future. I'm liking Labor Day 2019. I'm going to milk this sucker. Hope you do too. Have a great one. See you Tuesday.